which to ensure we not only meet those deadlines, but we actually have the appropriate data ready first of December. Thank you for the question.
Okay, no more questions of Amber Blackwell. We move on then, and it's the portfolio for neighbourhoods, housing and engagement. Are there any questions for Councillor George Davis? I've got Councillor Gilchrist. Can I make some comments? I did make it at the beginning of full council when I started this job. I have received a series of complaints about members using electronic devices during debates. I'm not going to name names, but it's not polite to look at an electronic device, whatever it is, while someone's trying to make a contribution in council. If I have to warn members in looking to it, I will begin to do so. But I have received unofficial complaints and I'm dealing with it in a manner I think we want to, is self-policing. But if it comes to the point where it's a distraction to the debate, I will take action. Thank you. Councillor Gilchrist, please.
As somebody who doesn't own an electronic device, I'm very can I ask Councillor Davis that the cabinet that discussed the corporate plan, reference was made to Ava Lane. As the item enabling new housing supply is mentioned in your report, and Ava Lane is mentioned in Councillor Jones' report, I wondered if it is the case that some social housing will be included or negotiated, whoever becomes the eventual purchaser of this land.
Thank you for the question there, Phil. I think it's a very important question you do need. Very difficult for me to say at this moment in time whether it's social housing or if it's private land. I don't know the answer to that as it stands at the moment, because the new philosophy is very important in times that where you have an agreement through a council where any more than 11 houses that are built, they have to be an element of social housing. I believe that has now been increased to 11, so that's the maximum in terms of implementing that route. I spoke to Phil today and Tom Harley in the past about our thoughts about how we move forward with this. I've made them known to our officers and hopefully this morning we'll come back to them. Okay?
Okay. Again, moving on. There's no other questions. Councillor Davis, Cabinet Portfolio for the Economy. Are there any questions of Councillor Pat Hackett? Yeah. Rob at the back, anyone else? No? What goes in opinion?
Right, thank you. Can a Cabinet member give us an update on item 3 of the report titled Recent Developments?
Recent developments. I think if people look at the report, recent developments concerns a number of schemes that have started, that are up and running or in the pipeline. The first one, as you can see, it's within the Wirral Waters developments. I mean, Wirral Waters obviously has been out for a number of years now, and it's progressing. There's a lot of work going on behind the scenes with officers and a lot of negotiating with the deal. I mean, it is the most, as we know, most awe-inspiring regeneration project of its kind in the whole of the UK. The biggest planning application in the whole of the UK, and of course, £4.5 billion over 30 years, with the objective of 27,000 jobs, which will change the landscape of the world, I would suggest, forever over that period of time. The actual projects in the report that have started on site include the structure of a new college on the Tower Road, which is to be completed by 2015. This exciting new project is due for completion, as I say, in 2015, the sort of about September 2015, and will provide Mr. Mayor the first key landmark, as I say, project on the Wirral Water site. It's one of the Mersey Waters Enterprise Zone. The new campus dedicated to delivering training and education, construction and the built environment, and providing skills and enterprise centre for local employers, and it will play a key role in the regeneration of the wider economy. The second one in the report is new office developments at Tower Wharf, which again is commenced. conclusion of this is due in November 2015. The other one, just to move on quickly, Mr. Mayor, is the Birkenhead Town Centre plan. Very exciting plan for the town centre, which is an absolute priority, of course, for this authority. And we are committed to working alongside Neptune Developments to deliver an attractive working vision for Birkenhead, which suits businesses, residents, developers, and attracts major investment into the town. And I think it's important as well that when we talk about investments, if the sort of investment we want to see is major regional, national, and international retailers and stores coming back into Birkenhead. And I think one of the keys with Birkenhead, which we haven't been able to do so far, is to link up Woodside with the Hamilton Quarter and with the town centre. I mean, there was talk of that traffic line back then with the Hamilton Quarter back a number of years ago. But I'm convinced we will do that. Our tourism officer, Mr. Bitt, is growing every day, and we want to replicate that kind of success in Wirral's largest retail centre. This is a huge area for developers with huge opportunities. It's our responsibility to ensure, in partnership with Neptune, that we allow Birkenhead to realise its fantastic potential. As I said, the plans for that, the master plan for that, will come to us all in early next year. And referring to Councillor Gilchrist's question at last council, obviously there will be a full and open process of consultation with residents, traders, and obviously local members before anything goes ahead. I think that's been the case today with any major scheme on the world when we think back. Just quickly to move on, so there, planning application submitted for major industrial and employment development by Red Sun Developments on land on the A41. Wirral Chamber of Commerce Development Pacific Road, small startup business units. Where is progress, as members know, with members working with them on the retail action plans across the borough in terms of our high streets. And lastly, but not least, to my own board, highway environmental improvements, works at the Brighton to support tourism and local businesses. And I just say, I mean, that's a classic example. We always have it from the other side that there's no development in Wallasey. I mean, in case some of the Wallasey members forget, New Brighton is actually in Wallasey, and it's created over 1,000 jobs, happened in a recession, and it's a tribute to all concerned. So let's get away from all this talk that's going to Birkenhead. That's 1,000 jobs, £70 million invested in Wallasey. It's a very broad scheme, and to do with the ground so far of our developments on the world. And that's the end of that roundup.
Okay, I did accept very late that just as you go on, Dave Mitchell's still up as well. So Dave Mitchell, a question for you, Pat.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. You've actually answered most of the questions. It was in relation to Birkenhead. I've been on the council long enough now. This is, I think, the fifth programme that we've had for redevelopment of the centre of Birkenhead. And it's changed every time we've seen it, it's changed. At one stage, it was in three different parts, like Central Station, bottom of Grange Road, top end of Grange Road, and the
sea. Which one of these, Dave?
The developments around the market. You did explain quite well that you took from one side of Hamilton Square and onto Conway Park. What about the other way to the station? Thank you.
So just saying, Mr. Mayor, I mean, Dave's right, and the plans when they come out early next year will be set in stone. And it is a big, huge area, and I think it's important to look at all aspects of it. And I think if we cast our mind back, if you write the development over 10 years, it changed and changed over the years. In reaction to the residents and traders' proposals. So it'll be the case with this, I'm sure, as time moves on. But having said that, we do want to move on with it, and we do want to do it, don't we? So it is important. And you know, the market, by the way, I actually worked in the market back in the 1970s, the old Birkenhead market, and the new one. And it does need a bit of invigoration, and a bit of regeneration. The canyon has gone through recently.
Okay, thank you, Pat. I can vouch for that. I bought my two-tone flares from the to Councillor Aidan Jones for support services. Any questions of Aidan? Okay, I've got Pat Cleary, Matt Daniel, and Jeff Green. Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Relating to item 4 on IoT, has the software package to be used in conjunction with the Windows 7 rollout been agreed? Is the council committed to using Microsoft Office packages rather than use free open source programs such as OpenOffice? If so, what is the cost?
Okay, we'll bring Matt in and then you go.
Thank you. Could Councillor Adrian Jones please give an update further to the one in his report following the collapse of buildings 85 to 87 on King Street, now called?
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Mayor. I wonder if Adrian mentions about the national payroll laws that agreement has been achieved. Just wonder if you want to give some details on that.
Okay.
I think yes, question for this, Mr. Mayor. We are in very close negotiations with the trade unions. We have got an agreement, and I'll make sure that we get a formal recommendation by you. If I go to Councillor Pat Cleary's question, firstly, thank you, Pat, for the courtesy of telling me about what it's going to be. That's obviously very helpful. You're asking about the way in which we're going to make sure I put it exactly as you're going to go to. You're concerned with the kind of software we're going to use, and you asked whether we would consider, we would give consideration to open. Microsoft. The answer is that we will be rolling out Office 10. Personally, I use Office 10 and Office 13 on both Windows 7 and Windows 8.0 machines. And I have a distinct personal preference for Windows 7 and Office 10. I think that's what we're all going to do. But in my experience, it's very handy because it's a simple step to go from what we already used to. That particular combination. But we will be, we will not be using open source for a series of reasons, but I'll give you some of the work that I have on it. Obviously, you'll be aware that Microsoft will only support XP until March 31st, 2015. Well, after that date, if new security vulnerabilities are discovered in XP, then we will also be risk from hackers who could have exploited them. There is some fear that there could be similar problems with hackers if we were to go on to open cloud. I'm not saying that open cloud can be made safe, but we do have an arrangement with Microsoft, which is felt to be the far the strongest way of protecting our councillors' material. So that is what the position is. However, because I know you want better quality information than that, I'll arrange for you to have something in writing within the next few days about sharing the announcements. What was the other question? Oh, yes. What happened in King Street? Thank you, Matt. We all know that some buildings in King Street collapsed. And there were all the usual rumours that you get in circumstances like that. But what has been discovered? Once the rubble was there to look at, was that at some time in the quite distant past, these buildings had been altered in a very incompetent and unprofessional way. The structure of the buildings had been changed, where a strong and necessary support wall for other floors had been changed, like it used to make one out of two. And once the building had collapsed, what could not be seen, but was the masonry and the last year was already there, was that the beams that had been used to support the upper stories were far inferior, not nearly stronger than where they were carried. And that is the fundamental way they collapsed. Well, now they have collapsed, and incidentally, we were at the point of auctioning that property. But now that they have collapsed, we have a space of clear, empty land, and I think the next thing will just give very serious consideration about the best
understanding was this been stopped because the company that might have developed the business case for the ones that do the challenge, is that not correct?
Thank you, could I just like to ask a question about the spotlight event, which I very much welcomed, and I very much agree the way that it highlighted the closer working arrangements in road safety and public health. And my question is this, that in the light of that meeting, does the cabinet member agree with me that the current allocation of public health, which I think is probably around about 1% to promote walking and cycling, that the amount that is allocated to that should be increased?
Thank you, Councillor, for your lovely questions. With the day services are concerned, Jeff, you've even had an extra really well that there was good consideration around the fact that the same company is actually doing the challenge, so there was an extra one brought in to that. So in a sense we double checked that everything is right for that fantastic project to go forward. And Canterbury House for the spotlight events, it was another really good event. And any councillor is more welcome to come to the spotlight events that we've had. We've had other ones on spotlight on the line, and really successful when Councillor George Davis involved around spotlight on housing and health. And yes, I think we should be encouraging people to walk and cycle, and that's one of the big things that the plan is concentrating on at the moment.
Okay, that was responsible to Councillor Chris Jones. Moving on now to Councillor Chris Mead, Cabinet Portfolio